I am the infidel.
Hey guys, another Q&A, and yeah, I got myself a new mug. It's starting to be a collection, actually. It's from Death, it's Scream Bloody Gore, and I think it's pretty sweet. I came across it in a CD store here in Amsterdam, and there's just one problem. I got in a spoon that if I want to keep my thumb on it, I have to bend my arm, and it makes me look a little bit like the Hunchback of Notre Dame. So you got to be creative in coffee drinking, so I'll just put my... What's that? Your index finger? Yeah, on top of it, and works just as good. So, like I said, another Q&A, and in this one I'll mix written questions like inbox messages and stuff like that together with video responses people made and video questions people made. So, I hope you like it. Here we go.
Hi, Infidel Amsterdam. This is YouTube name Heavy Cocaine. The thing I want to know is, what do you think about the band Elvite? Because I consider them one of my favorite bands.
Well, of course, Elvite will never be my number one band, because the genre I love most is death metal. But I do agree with you that they're really talented and it's a really good band. They really know how to create this ancient sound. They really make you think about the time that they're singing about. You know, I don't know whether you call it pagan metal, Viking metal, or folk metal. I mean, this whole genre discussion is getting silly anyway. But you say, my girlfriend is a really big fan of Elvite. She has a couple of CDs. And she even has a t-shirt, but there are a few songs that I really do like and which I have put on my telephone so I can listen to it, and on my MP3 player so I can listen to it at work. And a few songs that I really like are The Cauldron of Renaissance, Omnos, Memento, what do we got here? Inis Mona is a really known song, and Thousandfold on the new one, and yeah, you know, they got a couple of very, very good songs. So it's not my favorite kind of music, but I do like them.
I wanted to know if you believe in this. I know that you are against this true thing, but do you think that if some people like me, 16-year-olds, if they can consider themselves a true metal fan, even though they have just been listening to metal for 2 or 3 years, and if they can discuss on the internet about this subject? Because I have been having some arguments on the internet with people that have been trying to tell me that my musical beliefs are wrong, and that pagan metal sucks, like that's the music I listen to mostly, and how I have no idea about metal because I am just 16 years old, but I claim to have a good knowledge of metal, and I just wanted you to answer the question if you think that the age counts.
Well, it's actually, like I said in my video for Unidentified Lifeform, there are a lot of metalheads who claim to be real or true metal hats, and in a lot of cases they write true as TR00 or TRVE. If you write true like that, you're a dickhead anyway. Write your own language as it is supposed to. There is no true metal. Just like you said, I don't believe in that true bullshit. I was even a little bit younger than you when I started out with metal. I was 13, 14. Somebody gave me a Venom tape and he said, hey, you gotta listen to this, this is great. And the only music I heard up to then was whatever my mother and father were playing, like Tom Jones, Joe Cocker, Engelbert Humperdinck, stuff like that. So I wasn't really interested in music, and when I heard metal, I wanted to, you know, explore it further. So when you're young, you're not really going to read the history of metal. You just find new metal bands and, you know, you pass it on to others, like, hey, if you listen to this shit before, if you listen to this. So people who make up all these rules should make some sort of metal Bible, you know, so they can stick to that and make a church and get your ass in there. And, you know, there is no rule in metal. There are no rules in metal whatsoever. It's very simple. If you're if you haven't listened to metal before and you're on YouTube and all of a sudden you hit a metal video and you think, wow, this is cool, you know, whether it be speed, power, thrash, black, death, doom, gothic, whatever kind of metal, and you think this is great and you're going to explore metal from there, checking new bands out, and metal becomes the biggest portion of the music you like, you're a metalhead. Just like you say you like pagan metal the most, Ilúvatar, and that makes you a metalhead, no matter how old you are. If you like metal as the biggest music you like, you're a metalhead. It's not like some people I know that like Nothing Else Matters from Metallica, and after that they don't like metal at all. That doesn't make you a metalhead. But there are too many people who want to, you know, express themselves as the almighty knowing, the priest who preached to you about metal. You have to be like this, and you have to think like that, and you have to dress like that, and if you don't know that, if you didn't know that, you're not a metalhead. Bullshit. You know, you can have your own thoughts about metal, and you, other people can't agree with it, or they do agree with it. There are no rules, there are no facts, it's all about taste. And in my eyes, you're a metalhead.
And another question I have for you is, how long did it take you to grow that beard? Because it just looks so cool.
Well, I actually really don't know how long that took. I have been wearing a goatee, and that is just, you know, this piece, for years, and after a couple of years I was like, you know, I'm getting sick and tired of having to shave the sides every now and then and watch if I, you know, made it a little bit equal. And I was like, you know, that's my razor, I'll just throw it away. And I let the sides grow together with the rest of my goatee, and now it's an entire beard. But I do know that if I would shave my beard, it would take me, I think, 1.5 years or 2 years to grow it back to this, you know, to this length. It goes pretty quick. It goes quicker than my head hair, actually. So, I'll show you a couple of pictures of the difference in facial hair I had.
Yeah, and why did you go to the Big Brother show? I don't know if you answered that question already, but why? Why did you go there?
Well, I admit it's not the best show to watch on television, because the only thing you do is watch 12 people go into the house being complete strangers from each other, and because of that fact, people start fighting each other. I can talk hours and hours about it, because there were a lot of things that happened in the house. And I was working at a plaster company in the time, it was 2001, and I went to my boss after I went to a series of tests and conversations with people from the network, and they told me, you can be in the show. So I went to my boss, my employer, and I told him, like, can I get 3 months off without payment, because I can, you know, do this show. And he didn't believe me I could be in the show. He said, you know, they won't take you, so be gone. And I said, hey, fuck you, you know, I can get another employer, but Big Brother is just once in a lifetime. So I went there, and one of the funniest things that ever happened, they divided the Big Brother house in two. It was called Big Brother the Battle, and it meant that you had a rich side and a poor side. And on the poor side, you got, you know, every day a little bit of food, just enough to not be starving, and you had a cold shower, which was outside. And on the rich side, you had like a sauna and you know, showers, and you could spend €1,000 every day with six people on everything you wanted. But people got lazy. People stayed in bed until 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock in the afternoon, and Big Brother, the program, or the people from the network didn't want that. They wanted you to get out of bed and you know, fill your day. So what did they do? They played music at about 8 o'clock in the morning, and they told us, you can ask music if you want to. So I was on the poor side, and you can only order music on the rich side, and I was on the poor side for a long time. And everybody on the rich side was ordering, you know, music that you don't want to be woken up with. That people were ordering Britney Spears, some Dutch artists, Michael Jackson. If you're a metalhead, you don't want to be woken up with that in the morning. So I told my group, if we're on the rich side, I'll be the first one to order music, because the whole house is being woken up with it, even if you're on the poor side. So I went into that diary room, as they call it, and I said, I want to order music for tomorrow morning. And you're just watching a mirror, and you hear a voice talking to you, and you hear like, okay, what do you want to order? So I said, I want to hear Dark Funeral, The Arrival of Satan's Empire. And at first they were like, you know, Ed, it's cool that you like that music, but what are you doing? You know, you're going to wake everybody up with that noise. And I was like, okay, so I can be woken up with Michael Jackson, Britney Spears, you name it. And then I heard, yeah, you're right. So the next day, 8 o'clock in the morning, I jumped out of bed because I heard the intro from Dark Funeral. And everybody came out of bed like, what the fuck is this? What is happening? And I was headbanging in my underwear, you know, so that's one of the things that happened in there, which was really cool. And yeah, I think I look back at it with a lot of happy thoughts and with joy. I'm really glad I did it. It's a one-time, you know, once in a lifetime experience, and it was pretty cool.
What was the CD you bought that you listened to the least? That one interests me.
Well, I do have a CD which I once bought and never listened to it anymore after I listened to it once. And it's this one. It's supposed to be a death metal CD. It's from the band Secrecy. It's called Dictums of Power. And after listening to it, I thought the production was just too bad. It became really annoying to listen to it. And well, I didn't bring it back, or I didn't trade it for another CD. So it's still in my collection, but I actually never listened to it. Maybe I'll just do this in some sort of, I don't know, winning contest. If somebody wants to win it, I'll just think of something, and I'll just give this one away for free. So if you like this and you want to win it, keep an eye on my channel, because I'll just think of something to make somebody win this. How's that?
If you get a link from somebody for some underground band, would you give that band a shout out?
Well, sure. If I really like the band and I really like their music, I'll just, you know, make sure you people get to know about it too. And in a lot of cases, I'll see or I'll try to get in contact with the band itself. And I mean, I did it before. I did it with Cerebral Bore, with Karach Angren, with A Loading Requiem, with Quo Vadis or Quo Vadis or however you pronounce it. So I really like to tell you guys about music and about new stuff I found, and the best thing is to let you guys hear a little piece of music. So I always try to contact the band and to see if I can get their approval to, well, you know, let you guys listen a little bit to their music. So and I can find bands myself, and if you guys got a band in which you tell me you gotta check this out, I'll just use that and see if I can contact the band. So if you ever get something or a band from which you think you need to check this out, just keep it sending to me.
Oh yeah, and another thing, I am German and I have heard you on your videos, like where you made fun of this NSBM, like you talked a bit German. Do you speak German and do you understand German? That's something that would interest me.
Well, actually my German is not that good. The piece I did in that video, I translated everything I wanted to say on the internet, and I hear enough German to know how to pronounce it. I went to Germany 2 years ago with Jose and her parents, and we went for the snow, and it was really cool. But there was this woman who was the owner of the apartments we were at, and I had a bag of trash and I wanted to throw it away, and she was coming out of her window and saying plastic bottles go in that box and glass go in that box and paper go in that box, and I understood completely what she was saying, and I was like okay, so you know, I couldn't pronounce it or I couldn't talk back that quick. So my German is not that good. I understand it for a lot or a big deal, but no, to talk back is like yeah, you know. So no, my German is not that good.
So I wanted to know what will be your reaction if someone will cut your hair without a reason or with it.
So what you're saying is what my reaction would be if someone would cut my hair or my beard, reason or no reason. Well, I can be very short about this. I can handle a joke, and I joke about myself, I joke about other people, but these would not be jokes. My reaction actually would be, if you read Cannibal Corpse lyrics, that shit would come to life. You know, people like that, yeah, it would pretty much hurt really bad. Well, not anymore. I think I quit smoking weed or pot or whatever you want to call it right before I went into Big Brother, and that was in 2001. And before that I did it a couple of years. But the problem was, just like with any drugs, the first time I had a joint or a spliff or whatever, you know, you inhale twice and you're stoned, as we say here in Holland, stoned like a shrimp, you know. And after that you take an entire joint to get stoned, and then you take two joints to get stoned, and it keeps on going, you know. Before we knew it, and we were with a whole group, before we knew it we were smoking 10-12 joints to stay stoned the entire evening. So yeah, when it was 2001 I decided to quit smoking pot, and I still smoked cigarettes, which is also 2 years ago since I took my last one. So I don't do pot anymore. Well, I think it's pretty cool that you actually guessed how thick my rings are. I don't know if it's a segment ring or whatever. I'll just, you know, take it out and so you guys can see. It's a big plastic black ring. It has a ball. You can click it into, and that's the ring. I think it's three and a half years ago, maybe even a little bit longer. I went to a tattoo shop here in Holland, and out of the blue, I told the guy, like, you know, why don't you give me a couple of rings, and on both sides, because I got one right here. And after that, after like a week, I was like, these rings are too damn small. I was like 1.2 millimeters. And from there, I stepped up to a 3, then to a 5, and you know, so on and so on. And this is indeed actually an 8 millimeter ring. And maybe I'll just go up to a centimeter, but I don't want those tunnels or those gauges. You know, I don't want that. I'll just stick to a ring, and that's it. You know, I'm also not the type of person that takes piercings anywhere else. I tried an eyebrow piercing once, and after a week I was looking at myself into the mirror and I was like, no. So I screwed it out and I threw it away, and no, I'll just stick to a couple of rings on my ear, and that's it.
Hey Infidel, what's up? Just a quick video here, because of course I watched your video Good News, and recently I found out some more good news, and that more good news is that Amon Amarth are making a new album. They announced this year that they're releasing a new album next year. It's called Surtur Rising, and I'm telling you this because I know you like Amon Amarth. I love Amon Amarth, they're one of my favourite bands, and I know you like them. And just closing thing is, you've seen Amon Amarth live, so I'm just wondering, what are they like live? Because I'm going to see them live in April, so just wondering what they're like. And also, have you ever met Amon Amarth? Because it'd be cool if you've met those guys. That's all. Cheers. Thanks for watching, Infidel.
Hey, man. Yeah, you're right. I'm really excited for the new album, because their latest album, Twilight of a Thunder God, was a really good album. And, well, I got here two tickets for Yersay and me for another concert of Amon Amarth, and it's going to be the fifth time I see them, and in this case it will be Friday, May of 20 here in Amsterdam. Their support act is going to be, if I read correctly, the Black Dahlia Murder, which is not really my idea of a support band for Amon Amarth. But anyway, so I don't really have to hesitate to get, you know, to be the first one to be in line for the concert, because I'm not really a big fan of the Black Dahlia Murder. But as I said, it will be the fifth time I see them, and every time I saw them, I saw them four times now, they deliver. It's strange to, you know, use that word, but they deliver. You hear the album, you think it's great. If you see them on stage, it's even better. You know, their quality is just as good as on the CD, but their performance is just overwhelming. You know, Johan Hegg is like a monster standing in front on stage. He's really good interacting with the audience, and yeah, he's just a real Viking standing there. He has a great sound. The entire band is great, and yeah, you know, if you like Amon Amarth, if you like him on CD, don't hesitate to buy a ticket for a concert, because you're just in for a huge show, and it's going to be great. And I think it was the first time that Amon Amarth played in Amsterdam, or at least when I saw him in Amsterdam, and they were a support group for Dimmu Borgir. So I bought a ticket for Dimmu Borgir, and I never heard of Amon Amarth, and they came on stage, and I was completely blown away. I always keep like a little book, or I put it in my telephone. If I see a band and I never heard of that one before, same goes for Immolation. I saw Immolation for the first time together with Cradle of Filth, and actually I should have, you know, left after Immolation, because Cradle at that time wasn't too great live. So I asked someone, like, you know, what's this band, and they said Immolation. So I read it down, before I wrote it down, and after the first time I saw Amon Amarth, I went to a bar in Amsterdam, which is a metal bar, I used to work there for over a year behind the bar. I was a barkeeper, and not at that time, but I went there with my ex-girlfriend, and after the show, the entire group came into that metal bar. And when I was standing outside of the concert waiting for it to open before it start, I saw a lot of people in a glimpse looking at me and thinking I was Johan Hegg. And I was looking around like, what the hell are you talking about? And everybody was like, oh no, oh no. And that happened like, I don't know, at least 20 times. And I was like, what the hell are you looking at? You know, why are you looking at me? And when I saw Johan Hegg on stage, I was like, ah, he looks a little bit like me. So when Johan entered the bar, I went up to him and I tapped him on the shoulder. He turned around and I said, either you shave or I shave, because you look like me or I look like you, and everybody thinks that you're me and I'm you. So, and with that heavy voice Johan had or has, he told me like, no, 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 don't shave, man. The beard looks awesome, so don't shave. And that was pretty cool. So I went up to him and I said, hey, you know, you want to take a picture? Because I think your band really rocks. And so we did. So be sure to see Amon Amarth at least once in a lifetime. Oh, there's one more thing. I still get friend requests on Facebook, and perhaps you added me a while ago and you think to yourself, he still hasn't confirmed me. That is because my friends list on Facebook is full. It seems that there is a 5,000 friends limit on Facebook, and yeah, I reached that, so people can add me, but I can't confirm them anymore. Now, a while ago there has been made a fan page on Facebook. It's all about me. The owner or the creator may be a moderator, so I can change everything I want. You can go to that page and like it, so you can, you know, keep dropping comments for me or keep dropping questions for me. I'll put the link over there. It's officially called a fan page. I don't have fans, you know. I've got metal brothers and sisters, I've got viewers, I've got subscribers, I've got friends, you know, whatever you want to call yourself or whatever I want to call you. I got legionnaires. I think that's a cool phrase, but fans, you know, no, I'm not some sort of celebrity. I just do my thing, I do videos, and I just hope you guys like it. So, I'll put the link, like I said, over there, and you can like it so it's in your likes list, and see you guys next video.